one exciting night, isn't it? The McGarry Medal and South Australian Football Hall of Fame. Who's your tip?
Oh, it's an exciting night. Look, I'd love to see Nick Holland, I suppose. You know, Central's boy, and he's had a great year with us. And but, you know, there's other great players who are going to be involved. You know, Greg from Norwood, Joel Cross from South Adelaide. So, yeah, they're probably the top three I reckon I'll go with.
Obviously heavily involved still as an assistant coach with the Bulldogs. Nick Holman, he's got plenty of opposition from within, hasn't he, with Trav Schiller and also Chris Jansen?
Yeah, he has. You know, a couple of blokes who are blonde-haired and they certainly catch the vote. So, yeah, but I think Nick's has had a real good year, real consistent year. He's played 18 great games and... it'd be great for him, come off the list of Carlton, coming over to us over the last couple of years. He's been very, very consistent with us and a great fella as well. 30-odd years ago since I won it now, and the memories always keep coming back, and it's a great night for South Australian football, you know, and great night for someone who's going to win it tonight.
Well, James, thanks for joining us on Sandful TV. How do you think you'll fare tonight?
Not too much pressure on me. I'm just enjoying the night and good to be here. I think there's a couple other standouts than me this year, which has been good to watch, but nah, not too nervous at all.
Obviously missed, I think, the first seven rounds with that finger injury, so it's going to make it tough for you if you are to come home from the clouds.
Yeah, I think it'll make it a bit tough. Seven games are probably a bit too steep to come over, but nah, it's been a good second half of the year with the team as well, performing well on Sunday, so... I want a bigger, better things, I reckon.
Plenty of other double blues as well to take votes from you. Obviously, we all know Zane polls well and Aidan Riley.
Yeah, Zane's obviously a known poll getter with two McGarrys and Aidan's, of course. And also Patrick Wilson, I reckon, this year will get a couple of votes as well. So, Corey Beard down forward, there's a lot to choose from down at double blues.
And obviously, lovely Abby alongside of you today. Obviously, fantastic to come along to the event together and enjoy the night.
Yeah, she came last year. So this is our second one together. Okay. So, yep, she enjoys getting doled up into the nine, so it's good.
And Abby, how does James fare in the bathroom? How long does it take for him to spruce himself up?
Oh, nearly longer than me these days. Just for this night and a couple others. So, start best and fairest, and it takes a while.
What's the longest item he spends the most time on, the hair?
I'd say the hair, the beard sometimes.
Very good. And you're looking forward to the night?
Yes, can't wait. Yeah. It should be nice.
How do you think James will fare?
Yeah, I think he'll go well. I've heard a few things, but I think he'll go well.
Well, thanks very much for joining us, both of you, on Sandful TV, and enjoy the night at the McGarry Medal and Hall of Fame.
Thank you.
Joining me now is the Sandful umpiring director, Shane Harris, on the Serafino red carpet. And Shane, I would have thought this sort of thing, it's just exactly your style.
I'm right into it, Zach. Yeah, very nervous and just hope we haven't buggered anything up, really.
Who's your tip? Are you allowed to say your tip tonight?
Look, mate, I watch that much footy, I wouldn't know. We follow different sides, so, yeah, no, we wouldn't know. As long as we've got all the paperwork right and the best winner is the best winner.
The umpires themselves, no doubt they enjoy the night as well.
Oh, very much so, and it's fantastic the league provide them the opportunity to come. You know, our top umpires are here, and our couple of first gamers are here as well, so it's good for them.
Not quite as wild as the umpiring golden whistle, though, mate.
No, that's after the season. It's a bit like our Mad Monday, mate.
Well, Shane, thanks for joining us on Sandful TV, and enjoy the night.
No worries. Thanks, Zach.
Joining us now on the Serafino red carpet is Port Adelaide star Brendan Archie. And Brendan, how would you rate your chances of tonight?
Not very high, if I'm being honest. Look, I think I had a pretty good start to the year, but I played a few AFL games as well, which took me out of that SANFL race, and had blokes like Aaron Young and Jackson Trengo come back and perform really well. So not expecting to be a high vote getter, but it's my first McGarry, so I'm looking to having a good night.
Excellent. And Stevie Summerton, I would have thought, will poll a few votes. We know he's a proven poller.
Yeah, definitely. Summer's been a proven SANFL star for the last couple of years, and even blokes like Jimmy Tumpus and Brett Eddy, obviously winning the Ken Farm as well, take votes. So yeah, it's just going to be a good night to sit down with the boys and see you guys well. Awesome to get the win on the weekend, get the week off, and get prepared for one of the most important games of my career. I think I played in the 2014 grand final and lost, so I've, you know, I would really, really, really love to get SFL premiership because that's for life.
Joining me now on the Sandful Serafino red carpet is one of the favourites for the McGarry medal, Nord's Mitch Grigg. Mitch, how are the nerves coming in?
Pretty settled. I'm not really expecting much tonight, just ready to enjoy, have a few beers with the boys and enjoy the night.
How did you assess your first season back with the Red Legs this year?
I thought I started reasonably well and sort of tapered off through the middle of the year and finished, you know, okay. Just a solid year. I think I was reasonably consistent and nothing outstanding, just consistent.
Fair to say when you did that little bit of a taper off, so to speak, Matty Panos really came into his own as well, so he might poll a few.
Yeah, definitely. He's a quality player and we loved having him back. He was in and out the side with a few injuries and it was awesome to have him back in some really good form.
Enjoy your year back at the beloved Red Legs full time?
Yeah, definitely. Really started enjoying footy again and being back with a lot of players I won a flag with back in 13 was awesome. So, really enjoying being back at Norwood.
Well, joining me now on the Serafino red carpet is Woodville West Torrens veteran Paul Stewart. Stewie, nice to be at the McGarry medal. It's a great night.
Yeah, it is. Looking forward to it. Jared Pachenko or Boydie pull a few votes, or even Jack Johansson could probably get a few.
Staggering that no one from Woodville West Torrens has won the McGarry since the merger, isn't it? I guess just a trademark of the team being so even for so long.
Yeah, Michael Wunke actually just told me that on the way in, no one's actually won it. I said, well, yeah, I'm probably not going to poll a vote here tonight, so I'm not going to change that. But hopefully someone polls a few votes like Jack Johansson or Boydie or someone like that.
Funnily enough, Michael Wunke no doubt told you that he's won some Ken Farmer medals.
Yeah, he's told me that a few times, so he's got a few at home.
And nice to share the evening with Kira here as well.
Yeah, my fiancée Kira, she's come along for the night. We left the little one at home, so mm-hmm. So it should be a good night.